Welcome, guys, to yet another Legend of Zelda Let's Play for the channel. We've gone through all four of the other console-based 3D Zeldas, and we're left with just Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask, set in a timeline after young Link beats Ganon at the end of Ocarina of Time, where he goes off on his own little adventure away from the lands of Hyrule and to the lands of Termina. We're going to experience the whole game, and it's fairly different to, well, what you could say Ocarina of Time or normal Legend of Zelda in the way that it's very side quest driven as opposed to main quest driven. It's got a lot of little side quests to do. It's got the most collectible heart pieces of any Zelda, I think, that exists. And of course, a major collection system involving masks. So while we'd be seeing a lot of familiar kind of structures like the Gerudo here or familiar people, because it kind of takes place in its own little kind of weird parallel universe, we're going to see a lot of familiar faces, but in completely different lights than before. A completely different land, with a looming threat overhead at all times. So let's get into this here, while this lovely scenery plays here, and move on and experience Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. Let's go. So, time to create a file. Files. I'm playing the Wii Shop downloaded version. Of course, we're going with our hero of time, always named as Oliz. And stepping right into the adventure. In the land of Hyrule, there echoes a legend. A legend held dearly by the royal family that tells of a boy. A boy who, after battling evil and saving Hyrule, crept away from the land that had made him a legend. Done with the battles he once waged across time, he embarked on a journey, a secret and personal journey. A journey in search of a beloved and invaluable friend. A friend with whom he parted ways when he finally fulfilled his heroic destiny and took his place among legends. Hee-hee, you two fairies did great! I wonder if he has anything good on him. Huh? This guy? Well, that shouldn't be a problem. Ooh, what a pretty ocarina! Hey, Skull Kid, let me touch it, I want to see! You can't, Tail! What would we do if you dropped it and broke it? No way, you can't touch it! Oh, but sis, why can't I try it out too? Thank you. Our hero is not having a good day at all to start this game off. Skulk has even managed to kidnap Epona. What can we get here? All lovely rupees. And it looks like, of course, Link's been given a little bit of a slight makeover, a little bit of graphical touching up on himself, which is pretty nice to see. In fact, the Hylian shield seems completely different, if it is even the Hylian shield. But while we can get these rupees, let's pick them up nice and fast. Already starting with sword and shield is always a good way to start the game. Let's give chase. And it must have hurt to be dragged along like that, that's for sure. So are we heading up here? Ooh, crazy flips he does now. Let's go, Link. Acrobatic child. And that's why it's a good idea not to just run without looking. I'm gonna probably do that a lot in this Let's Play. Right. Crazy colors. What's going on? Oh, lucky. What's with that stupid horse of yours? It doesn't listen to a word that's said to it. There's no point in riding a thing like that, so I did you a favor and got rid of it, hee hee. Ah, boo hoo, why the sad face? I just thought I'd have a little fun with you. Oh, come now, do you really think you can beat me as I am now? Fool! Hee-hee, now that's a good look for you. You'll stay here looking that way forever. Why on earth is a fairy being allowed to beat me up? Sis! Well, this continues to be a really bad day. Whoa, whoa, Skull Kid, wait for me, I'm still here! Tell, you can't leave without me! You! If I wasn't dealing with you, I wouldn't have gotten separated from my brother. Well, don't you just sit there, Deku boy, do something! Why are you looking at me like this? What is there? Something stuck in my face? Will you stop staring and just open that door for me? Please, come on, a helpless little girl is asking you, so hurry up! Oh, Tail. I wonder if that child will be alright on his own. Oh, you're a bossy little fairy indeed, but we've been transformed! In fact, while we've been transformed, we can walk on water. Crazy. So we've got to open up this door, have we, madame? We can attack still, it seems. Crazy spinning ease. And, like, hurricane everything to death. Hello? We'll open this door then. So even in our morph state, which is pretty horrifying, we can still open doors at least. Hey, wait for me! Don't leave me behind! So, that stuff back there, I, apologize. So take me with you. You want to know about that skull kid who just ran off, right? Well, I just so happen to have an idea of where he might be going. Take me with you and I'll help you out, deal? Please? Yeah, okay. Good, so then it's settled. Now then, I'll be your partner, or at least until we catch that skull kid. My name's Tatl, so, it's nice to meet you, or whatever. Now that we've got all that straightened out, can we stop messing around and get moving? If I figure something out, press up and I'll tell it to you. Hopefully you'll manage to get by without my help until then. Breaking the fourth wall there, Link. You ding 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 all you like, but it does appear that you can't get across. It seems instead of a hey or a listen, Tatl calls us with a little ding ding ding. Hey, if I call you, press up right away. I can tell you're not very used to your Deku Scrub body yet. Well, no, because I'm not a Deku Scrub. Alright, listen up. If you press and hold A as a Deku Scrub while standing on a Deku flower, you can dive into it. If you wait a bit before releasing A, you'll launch out of the flower. Press A while flying to descend. Did you get that?
Yes.
Are you sure? I am. One more thing, press A when you're on the ground to perform a spin attack. A very, very nice spin attack that cuts everything even if I don't hit it. So now I'm in the plant and I just launch myself over, I'm guessing. With lovely little flowers leading the way. So A just to drop down when I need to, yeah. I can make flowers at will then. Something over the other side there, like a tree with a slight features, right. Let's just get over there, there's a treasure chest. Oh, you gotta hold down A to be able to launch high. So we're just looking to get over to each flower and making our way across the ravine. It's not been a good day for Link so far, has it? In fact, wait a second. Can I actually even make that? That seemed way too high. Does holding it down longer make me go up higher? Maybe not. Maybe I can make that. Ooh, just barely. We got ourselves a Deku Nut. Press B while flying to drop a Deku Bomb. Upon impact, it makes a blinding flash, freezing enemies in their tracks. But as a bomb, that sounds pretty good. Let's bring up the menu. Equip our bombs, right. So now it appears on our menu just to use it as B while we're flying, but we need to make it all the way over there. I imagine we should be able to make it from here. Oh, wait a second, there's only a limited time we can fly? I know, it appears that we lose speed, so we don't necessarily drop to nothingness land. Well, that's good to know. Nowhere else to travel to, it seems. Let's go for the gap. And round to the right-hand side. So we should be fine no matter what, but... Oh! Really? So it let us last forever previously, but it didn't let us last forever that time. Baffling. I wonder if there's any reasoning behind that, or... Right, so we need to get on that one, but we need to go to a straighter route, more or less. Say annoying. Let's get used to our Deku Scrub ways. Make it around the place. So how long do these plants last for? That's the real question. I'm not making it that way, we're gonna make it to that platform. And hopefully keep waggling. Ugh. Hey you, come on, press Z and talk to me. I will. There you go, see, you can do it if you try. When I fly over to people or objects, use Z to look at them so you can talk to them. Sure, use Z targeting to talk to people even if they're far away. The traditional tutorial. Or if there's no one to target, you can use Z to look straight ahead. But enough for that now, come over to this tree and check it out. More or less use L with my GameCube remote. Get on the middle, dive, and let's get over. So what exactly is it then, Tatl? It's strange, but the way you look right now sort of looks like this tree. It looks all dark and gloomy, almost like it could start crying any second now. How sad. What is it then? It does have facial features. I'm a bit worried about Skull Kid pulling more pranks on other people. And thankfully, I seem to have got the long straw. Seems that we may have ended up being warped. Music changing signifies that quite a bit. I can't go back, couldn't open up the door. Let's find out where we are. This isn't the forest anymore. We're not in Kansas anymore, Toto. Where on earth are we? You've met with a terrible fate, haven't you? Hello, masked man. Where are you hiding? I own the Happy Mask shop. I travel far and wide in search of masks. During my travels, a very important mask was stolen from me by an imp in the woods. So here I am at a loss, and now I've found you. Now don't think me rude, but I've been following you. For I know of a way to return you to your former self. If you can get back the precious item that was stolen from you, I will return you to normal. In exchange, all I ask is that you also get back my precious mask that the imp stole from me. What? Is it not a simple task? Why, to someone like you, it should be by no means be a difficult task. Except, the one thing is, I'm a very busy fellow, and I must leave this place in 3 days. How grateful I would be if you could bring it back to me before my time here is up. But yes, you'll be fine. I see you are young and have tremendous courage. I'm sure you'll find it right away. Well then, I am counting on you. I'm glad, Mr. Automatic Pose Changer Bloke. What's going on? Why, hello, did you find that little imp? We haven't found him yet. If you can get back the precious item that was stolen from you, I will return you to normal, we know. Surely you should be able to find him right away. Time continues to pass, even as we speak. There are only 72 hours left. Please do not forget my precious mask. I remember how much that phrase scared me the first time I played this. Dawn of the first day, 72 hours remain. As we enter Clock Town. He gives me the creeps. That mask salesman was the... Sorry, just thinking aloud. But 3 days? Even if we never sleep, that still leaves with a measly 72 hours. Talk about demanding. Well, don't just stand there. We're going to see the Great Fairy. Look, you want to find the Skull Kid, don't you? The Great Fairy will know what he's up to. She watches over everything. And just between you and me, the Skull Kid is no match for the Great Fairy. Go to the shrine near the North Gate. You'll find the Great Fairy in there. We will indeed. Only 72 hours remaining, as you can see, the day is moving. I'm guessing no one's going to talk to me. Hey, apprentice, don't just stand around looking at the sky all day. Why would I do such a thing? Because that's why. Huh, the moon? Looks ominous, that's for sure. Hello, sir. You have a mask on. Give me your mask. Also, where's the North Gate? The hours are ticking! Give me your mask! Right, we're in the laundry pool. And we've met a frog. Hello, frog. We cannot talk to you. You can rib it all you like. It's some kind of weird fairy contraption. Right, please hear my plea. The masked Skull Kid has broken me apart and scattered my pieces. Please find a way to return me to the fairy fountain in North Clock Town. Oh, wait. You're kidding me, right? You're not the Great Fairy, are you? Just, like, separated into multiple parts, because that would really suck. Where'd that kid go with the mask? It's locked! Well, he doesn't want to face us, that's for sure. I do like these little bounces we're doing, but... I think a nasty fate has met our great fairy here, if there's fairy shards and fairy parts all over the place. Now let's head north, whichever way north is. I wish I had a compass here. Oh, hello. Stop right there, Deku Scrub. Do you intend to return to the swamp alone? It is dangerous outside the town walls, so I cannot allow a child like you to leave unaccompanied. You are not allowed to pass through here without an adult until you are old enough to carry a weapon. Really? You're that careful of a Deku Scrub? This post is an eyesore. What a sorry collection of cowards. Blur, yuck, foo. Are you spitting on it? Recruiting soldiers, protect peace and uphold justice with this corpse recruiter, Vissen. We're not after that, we're after the Northern Fairy place. And we're seeing a lot of new lands and a juggling people. We're in the east of the clock town, right. Let's keep moving along with speed. Hello, juggling guys. We know who you are from the previous game. The gossip fellows, my, my. Funny things are happening in town, aren't they? Funny, funny. You're telling me, like the rumors about the swamp to the south? Did you hear about the kidnapping? Oh my, the kidnapping! Yep, but then the kid woke up. Get it? Kidnapping? Ha! Huh. I caught a million of them! Ho 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 ho! What weird guys are still weird as ever, and there's a mailbox! Deposit mail here. Ka-ching! Press start to open the select item screen. Choose and use an item with C. Thank you for using the postal system. Ka-ching! Oh no, this might be why everyone was wondering that I'd be starting a catchphrase yet again. Will there be many mail-type pursuits? How many times will there be me saying this? Hello, kid! If you want to pass through here, you have to say the secret code. Oh, that's a horrible number. Wrong! Jim said I can't let anyone who doesn't know the code in. If you're not a member, they won't teach you the secret code. If you want to be a member, go see Jim in North Clocktown. We're heading there. We'll see Jim soon. If North Clocktown is this way. We found the mayor's residence. That's not the Great Fairy's Fountain, however. Some random balloon that has the mask of the Skull Kid on the front. We are in North Clocktown. Right then. And it looks like a fairy fellow that we wish we'd never ever met. Making his first appearance in the series, chronologically, I think. What's this? Green clothes? White fairy? Sir, could you by chance be a forest fairy? Oh my! My name is Tingle! I think I'm the same as you, sir, a forest fairy! Alas, though I'm already age 35, no fairy has come to me yet. My father tells me to grow up and act my age, but why? I tell you, Tingle is the very reincarnation of a fairy. Now, while I stand here waiting for a fairy of my own, I sell maps to help out my father. Lucky, lucky, you're so lucky to have a fairy. I know, we should be friends. Yes, yes, in exchange, I'll sell you a map for cheap as a sign of my friendship. How much is cheap? Will you buy one of Tingle's maps? Clocktown? We can buy Clocktown. I'll buy Clocktown. Yippee! You got a map of Clocktown, now you can find your way around town. Great, the red arrow on the map shows where you entered and the yellow arrow shows your current location. Well, cool again. Tingle, tingle, kululimpa. These are the magic words that Tingle created himself. At least it's not become readable at the end. Don't steal them. I'll steal them all I like. Time is ticking away and it's horrific. All the grass is dying in a really weird fashion. It's all fluttering around me. Okay. Time is passing. What's up, kid? Huh? What do you want, shrimp? I'm busy practicing my blowgun. If you can't pop that balloon, then don't mess with Jim, girl. So you must be Jim, then. Okay, we obviously can't go this way. So the real location we're heading... Maybe I can bomb it. Would you like me to bomb it? Tatl, what's up? What are you doing? Aren't you going to take this fairy to the shrine near the north gate? We are! Whoa, look at the time! You don't even have 3 days left! I know I don't! Where can I head from here? I don't think I can head over that... Oh no, can I? Ooh, made it! Right, is this the shrine? Deku Scrub Playground down this hole. There's a playground down here. Let's play! Hello! I'm a fellow Deku's grad, and I want to say hello to you guys. In a crazy... What are you? How about it? Will the young one play? One game is 10 rupees. We'll play a mini game for the end of the episode. All right then, use this Deku flower and have fun. So we got to land on all the rupees? If the time it takes you to get all the rupees is faster than the current record, you get an extravagant prize. But if you fall down below just once, it's over. The best time for today's game is 1 minute 15. Right, get all the rupees faster than that. Okay, burn to the Deku flower. The game begins the moment you jump out. Which one's first? Left or right, left or right, left or right, left or right, left, left, left. But the left's gonna go really high now, and it's gonna be really bad. Right, we can make it. Go, go me. Cool, we got that one. Obviously the middle one is our next stop. Well, maybe I should wait till it's at the height of the platform before I launch myself off into a distant terrain. It does make a little bit of sense. Oh no, I missed completely! Too bad, you're done! So we've got a mini game here. You can beat as many times as you like though. If you have rupees, we'll continue with this at the start of the next episode, because a mini game usually leads to heart pieces galore or great prizes. And I love prizes, right? But we really should meet up with this great fairy. Time is a ticking. We do not want time to pass without doing stuff. Is this the Great Fairy Shrine? Alright, there's loads of little fairies here. Oh no, the Great Fairy! What's happened to the Great Fairy? Look, obviously it's not a Great Fairy anymore. We have found a fairy of our own though. Is that enough to reform? Whatever it is? Hello, fairy! You look just as creepy as Ocarina of Time, ha! Tatl, and you, young one of the altered shape. Thank you for returning my broken and shattered body to normal. I am the great fairy of magic. I thought the masked child was helping me and I grew careless. All I can offer you now is this. I shall grant you magic power as a sign of my gratitude. Please accept it. But Tatl was kind of saying that you could defeat the Skull Kid and... would make me feel better, not woozy. I'm very woozy right now. If you'd knock me unconscious, lady, I'm back to normal, right. I say back to normal, but I'm still a Deku scrub. You've been granted magic power in your current form. Press B to shoot bubble blast. Press and hold B to blow a big bubble. Release B to shoot it. Your magic power decreases when you shoot. Replenish it with magic jars and potions. The man who lives in the observatory outside of town may know of the Skull Kid's whereabouts, but be careful. So I've got to get outside town, despite the fact that the guards won't let me out. You must not underestimate that child's powers, kind young one. If ever you are returned to your former shape, come see me and I shall give you more help. I always appreciate help. But with that, guys... comes the end of the first episode of Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask, and with time ticking on the clock as we pass one. I bid you guys farewell, and join me for the rest of the Let's Play. Subscribe to me, subscribe to the show, and I will see you guys for the next episode tomorrow. Bye-bye.